Hey, everybody. I'm Tammy Cody from SketchUp for interiordesigners.com. And today I'd like to share with you my top three strategies for keeping my file size low. I know this may seem like a boring topic to cover and to think about, but it's actually really important as you draw in SketchUp from day to day to try to keep that file size as low as possible for a number of reasons that I'm going to cover along with those top three strategies. So let's dive in. Before we talk about how to keep our file size low, let's talk about three reasons why we want to keep our file size low. Number one is just simply it's going to run faster as we're working on it. In this coffee shop model, this file size is a little bit large, it's not too bad. And as I orbit, it's running somewhat smooth, but as that file size grows, as I zoom, pan, add objects, it's just gonna start to creak and run more slowly. And that's gonna transfer into layout. When I go to document this in layout, layout's gonna run slowly if the file size is quite large. Reason number two, emailing or sharing it with somebody else. When I email this to somebody, I'd like to keep it as low as possible so that they're not dealing with a very large file and having to figure out ways to make that smaller as they work on it. You can often get file sizes low enough to attach to email services like Gmail or Outlook. Gmail has a 25 megabyte limit, and then it will send it through Google Drive, or you'll need to send it through something like OneDrive or Dropbox. And doing that causes an extra step and sometimes extra expense. And the third reason is just simply room on your computer. You don't want to have to take up extra room on your computer unnecessarily. All right, so let's dive in to the three strategies. Just for reference, as a starting point, you can see that this pop-up coffee shop concept of mine is at 37.6 megabytes. So not quite small enough to attach to an email. I'd have to use Dropbox or Google Drive or something like that. So let's see if we can get it below 25 or even lower so that we can really easily manage this file. It's a pretty small space, so it should be doable. My first strategy is to simply purge the model. This is free, built into SketchUp. Nothing extra is needed. You can simply go to Window, Model Info, and then Statistics. Window, Model Info, Statistics, Purge Unused. So what is happening when we do this is that any unused styles, materials, geometry, all of that is getting purged from the model. And before I click on that, I want to show you an example of that. So in my styles, if I go to Select and then in Model, you can see my list has a few styles, more than three. I only have three scenes, which are using up one, two, or three styles. So I shouldn't be using all of these. I don't need SketchUp to hang on to this. Along with, I don't need SketchUp to hang on to materials that I'm no longer using or geometry that I've deleted, like something from the 3D warehouse, maybe a large polygon, a large file size sofa or something like that. So I'll go ahead and hit Purge Unused, and it's going to think about it, and you'll see all of these styles go away except for the few that I'm using in these scenes. So that's a great way to just clean out periodically our SketchUp file, and I recommend doing that at least once a day as you're working on it, if not every few hours as you work in SketchUp. I'm going to close that. We'll save the file and take a look at our file size. All right, back in my Finder window, let's take a look at that file size. We're at 15.9. We're already exceeding my expectations for this file. We can attach it easily to an email with most email providers. So let's see if we can get it even lower. If this were a bigger space, it wouldn't be so easy. So let's move in to strategy number two. And that is taking a look at our materials. Often we will import materials to use as textures, and the resolution is just much too large for what we need in SketchUp. So you can install a free extension called Material Resizer. You can find that in the extension warehouse, install it. It's ready to go right out of the box, free and easy to use. I have it installed already, so I'm going to go to Extensions, Material Resizer. And this is what it looks like. It's pretty basic, and you can see it has a list of all of the materials in my model, especially now that I've purged them. It's a pretty short list. So if I click on Size, I can filter out materials that are larger than a certain pixel size. So I don't need to do that because it's such a short list. I can see right away where I'm at. But this one right here, this is my pavers that are in the floor area here. Let's go ahead and resize our top two materials and see how we do. So we don't actually need them to be so large. And this cardboard texture, it's probably something so insignificant in my model that it doesn't need to be high resolution. So I'll keep clicking on these. I think this one I may keep. Not actually sure where that one is. We'll just kind of leave it there. Now, before I reduce these, I do want to point out that this is a destructive process. So it's not easy to undo. You will have to reinstall this texture if you want to bring it back to its original size or if it somehow gets messed up. So you may want to save a copy of this before you do this. It's just file, save a copy as, just to keep those old materials intact if you ever need to go grab them. All right, so I'm going to select those four. I'll just reduce the material even to like 700 pixels and then hit go. And it's going to reduce all four of those instantly. I can close this. I'm going to go ahead and purge my model one more time. So window, model info, statistics, purge unused, just to make sure that that file size is purged from the model. Save this, and then I'll head back over and check out my file size. We were at 15 point something before, and now we're at 12.3 megabytes, which is pretty darn good for a working SketchUp file that I can email, I can send a layout. It's very manageable. That's a great number. But just in case you don't have a great number at this point after using those two strategies, if your file is still quite large and you're wondering why, let's talk about the third strategy, which is looking more deeply at the objects that are in your file. So I'm going to close this and we'll dive into another free extension, which is the CG Impact Report. So that's another free one. You can find it in the extension warehouse, CG space impact space report. And once you install it, it'll be ready for you to use in your extensions drop-down panel here. CG Impact Report, again, another really simple and easy to use extension. You may need to expand the window. So these are all of the groups and components that are in my file. So you can see the totals over here on the right, and this is the number that we would like to keep an eye on. If you click on the total title here twice, it will pop the largest item to the top. So you can see group number four, whatever that is the heaviest item in my file. So if I click select, it's going to easily let me see what that is. So you can see it's a lot of that foliage, which is no surprise. Foliage almost always is the culprit for what's weighing down our file. And in this case, it's pretty vital to my file, to the design of it, and I like the way it looks. So I'm going to leave it in there, especially since my file size isn't that big right now. I'll click out into some white space here to unselect that. And let's take a look at the other objects. So if I hit select again, I can see other pieces of foliage on that second piece there. Deselect that. And then we can see this coffee, this pour over guy here. The third one is the third culprit. And there are six instances of it in my file. So that means that I may need to find a different one or leave it if, again, it's vital to my design. Or I can put it on a tag and turn off that tag to make the file run faster. It won't reduce the file size, but it will help me speed it up, which is a whole nother video where we talk about tags and shadows and styles, things like that. We'll get to that in a future video. But for now, if you want to delete these from the file, that would reduce the file size. But I'm going to leave them there. I'm actually happy with my file size. If you can't find something by simply hitting select, like if it's hidden under something else, you may want to turn on X-ray mode to just take a look if you can figure out what is blue and selected. If you still can't find it, you can always copy the title here. So this circle 0.001, I'll hit Command or Control C to copy that title. And then I'll head over to my outliner and I can search for that. So I'll paste it, Command or Control V, and I can close out of this for a moment here and take a look as I drill in to these groups here. And there it is. And if I click on that title, it will activate that group or component. So you can see it's actually the lid in this coffee cup. So that is one of the items that is weighing down my file. So I may want to consider deleting this or again, putting it on a tag and turning that tag off as I work on my file. Again, the tag strategy does not reduce the file size, but it does make it run faster as you work on your file to have that not visible. All right, so I am, again, am happy with my file size. I'm not going to delete anything from this. If I did delete, say, this coffee cup, I would need to tap delete my keyboard and then, of course, purge my file, because just because I've deleted that coffee cup doesn't mean that SketchUp doesn't remember it. So again, delete items that are unneeded and weighing it down so that you can replace it with something else, and then go to Window, Model Info, Purge Unused. All right, those are my three strategies for lightening up a file. I hope that was helpful. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments.